Hello, most of you guys know me as that one-trick Torb idiot on ladder known as Cum Goblin. In this video, I'm going to give you guys 6 important tips and or mechanics to factor into your own Bjorn gameplay to terrorize the rank ladder and your opponent's backlines. Before we fully dive into the video, I have an important general tip for every Overwatch player watching this video. This can be applied to any player in any rank and is essential to understanding how to maximize the value of your own character. An issue I've noticed through my time playing Overwatch is that lower rank players and even some higher rank players do not know the damage values of the characters that they play. This can be essential in understanding how to maximize the value your hero can have in a ranked game or any game of Overwatch. Since this is a Torb tips video, I'll only be covering Torbjorn's kit. But remember to apply this tip to any hero you play and do your full research on that hero to give yourself the best chances of winning your Overwatch games. Torbjorn's rivet gun has 2 fire options. His left click or primary fire deals 70 damage to the body and 140 damage to the head. Although it is a projectile, it has the same damage statistic as McCree's Peacekeeper, except Torbjorn's projectiles have no falloff damage, which you can use to your advantage. If you notice, he shoots out little molten nails, which kind of resemble Cheetos, which has caused me, personally, to call them Cheetos in-game. Torbjorn's right click or secondary fire is a burst shotgun that does 105 damage to the body. It shoots 10 pellets that each do 10.5 damage and has a maximum damage range of 10 meters before falloff begins. Because this shotgun has such a short range and has such immense pellet spread, it is actually frowned upon to use the shotgun in most situations where you would want to use his Cheetos. However, it can be very good for breaking shields, finishing low HP targets, and pressuring tanks to use abilities. The next weapon in the meatball arsenal is the coveted hammer. I like to call it the baby Reinhardt hammer, because it does 55 damage, opposed to Reinhardt's 75, which is slightly less, but compared to the average 30 damage melee, it's basically like you're running around with a little mini Reinhardt hammer. It can be used to assert dominance over your enemies in ranked, and it has one very important tactile use, which we will get into with the first tip. When on the front lines as Torb, your greatest advantage is also your biggest weakness, your ammo. Torbjorn takes a whopping 2 seconds to fully reload his rivet gun, which can be the decisive factor in killing an enemy, you not finishing a target, you dying, or many other scenarios. I have this happen a lot against Reinhardts. You pressure them, get them down to 1 HP, they flicker their shield, jump away, and you're unable to finish them because your team comes back and supports them. Rather than trying to reload or meleeing them, which only can do 30 damage, whip out the hammer. Show Reinhardt who has the bigger hammer. As underrated as it may be, Torbjorn's turret is essential to his playstyle. It allows for a 6.5 versus 5 team fight, does extra poke damage, and is an overall annoyance to the enemy team. The turret can also give Torbjorn 500 HP instead of 250. This is great for dueling widows, or characters that normally outrange you. You can place the turret in front of you and use it to body block any damage, and prevent enemy snipers from hitting your crit box. You can also use this trick to spam chokes where you think you might take poke damage that you don't want to sustain on your person, but rather your turret. Continuing with Torbjorn's turret, we will talk about when and how to repair or replace it. In the event it has taken damage, 9 times out of 10 you will wait for it to be done firing and replace it with a new one. I almost never destroy my turrets with interact keys, as it is pretty much a useless test. If your turret has taken damage and it is currently firing, don't destroy your turret. Let it live out its life cycle and replace it with a new one. If it is done firing and it has sustained damage, just throw a new one. You don't need to waste the time pulling the hammer. Moving on from his arsenal, let's talk about the Swede himself. As Torbjorn, you want to place yourself in positions where the enemy is vulnerable, but you are not. Thinking about getting off angles where you can do damage without receiving much, or getting into a position to do direct damage to enemies behind shields, as shown here, can be essential to maximizing the value you have on Bjorn. Now that we've covered the basics of his kit, let's talk about what everyone loves to discuss. The Coom. When Cooming is Torb, please tap fire your Coom. You don't want to blow your load in one shot because this can lead to multiple issues. First off, your load is not spread out to its maximum value, which sucks because you just wasted part of your ult, right? Secondly, when you hold down M1, your ult stacks. Your different blotches, they stack. You don't want them stacking. You can rapidly tap fire your ultimate, but do not hold it down. With that one out of the way, my final tip also involves coom. When erupting, talk to your teammates about what you're doing and try to maximize your ultimate's value. Combo it with Orisa Holt, Hog Pulls, and any other abilities that displace the enemy. If you're feeling extra spicy, you can splooge into the black hole. But remember that you're using two high value ultimates in a single throw. Those were my 6 basic Torbjorn tips to improve your gameplay. Thank you all for watching so much, but before you go, I have a small PSA. If you're going to play an off-meta character, or honestly any character in general, please communicate with your teammates. It provides a better experience for not only you, but everybody else in the game. And it'll help you win more. And who doesn't want to win, right? Just please join team chat, talk it up with your teammates, have a blast. Remember, ranked isn't always that serious. Have fun with it. Oh, and also, you can catch me streaming at twitch.tv/cxmgoblin69. Mwah.